This podcast contains strong language and adult themes from the outset. Strap yourselves in, baby. It's taken me all week to recover from Saturday. I have to say, I woke up this morning feeling better.
What happened on Saturday, Janine?
Oh, my birthday party, didn't I?
Happy birthday.
A birthday party that wasn't really my birthday, but I decided to do it early for the weather.
Yeah, it was good, wasn't it?
It was fine, wasn't it?
Although it was a little bit wet, wasn't it? It started to rain a little bit.
Oh, yeah, but you know what? It was dark by then and everybody was inside. But the early part of the evening, everybody was sat outside, which was nice.
It was so warm, wasn't it?
Yeah, yeah. But, and Rashida, I'm sorry, Rashida, she fell over. I say fell over, she tombstoned herself.
That was well after I left her.
Yeah.
Right. I mean, we left at about half 11.
My forehead is still... the thing is, you know when you get those bruises, but there's nothing there to show you that there's a bruise? Right? My forehead, it's still tender to touch.
Your forehead?
Yes.
Did you headbutt someone as well as punching someone?
When she fell over... She hit the back door. The force of her falling against the door smashed me in the middle of my forehead. So I've had a headache for 3 days.
So you want to wallow in some more of your self-pity?
So, that video.
People love it.
So.
People absolutely love that video. And they're like, does your mate know? And I'm like, you know it's Janine. Yeah, I know it's Janine. Does your mate know that she hit him, like... In the sternum, I'm like, yeah, I reckon she knew that's what she was doing.
Yeah.
Because they're like, God, did he move? And that's why he kind of, he braced and he pulled himself down. I'm like.
No, let's get the full story, right? Well, I don't actually remember him grabbing my tit, but I do remember giving him a wallet because he was trying to grab me, wasn't he?
Yeah, he was talking, I think you were talking about early on in the night, the boys went to kind of go grab your tit and you went, whoa, don't do that. I've got no bra on because I've got a backless thing.
That was then David.
He starts walking round to kind of be Billy Big Bollocks and...
Try and grab him.
Yeah. And you had quick reactions.
Boom, straight in. And then I said to him, he's like, ooh. I said, yeah, that hurt, didn't it? I said, that wasn't even full power. Oh, well, how much was it? I said, about 60%. I said, do you want to go again? You want to feel full power? And that's because he loves a bit of attention, does Goyma, doesn't he? Are you filming? Have you looked at the original video? Are you filming? Right?
Yeah, I did cut that bit out.
But he doesn't come off in it. You know, as well as he should.
No, I like the bit, right at the end he goes, Christ.
So funny. I mean, slow down. I said to one of my mates, I said, yeah, that wasn't even like, I didn't give that a proper welly. And one of my mates at the Phoenix watched it. He looked at my face, he went, you're talking absolute shit. When you slow it down, you can see my face in it, right? How much welly I'm putting into that shot. The videos I don't ever think they do justice, but yeah, I mean, you know.
Well, that's why because I was watching it, I was like, I wonder if I slow this down, and then I managed to get that audio from the last podcast.
I'm so angry. I'm just an angry person.
Yeah, it was brilliant. And then I managed to get the screen, the cover shot, where you're just contacting him, and he's like, oh!
Yeah, this face is classic, man.
So I thought that was great.
I laughed my tits off. You know, I don't take myself too seriously.
It took me quite a while to do that. Like, it didn't take me that long to slow it down, but to get the audio and blah, 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 I think that was worth it.
You know I don't take myself seriously, but you know what? If I want to be single for the rest of my life, that's the video that's going to do it.
Get ready. Wait. Leave nothing out.
Don't threaten me. You don't scare me. And when you're headed down...
Leave nothing out.
So, yeah, so it's morning. I was actually thinking that when you came here, I was like, oh, this will be different.
Yeah, because usually we're hanging out our asses when we do it in the evening.
I haven't done any exercise yet today.
No, I've walked the dog.
Oh, they're staying.
And he's still got the shits.
Oh.
He's had the shits for a few days. Poor little bugger. I can't give him carcasses anymore. He can't pull them out. Honestly, he goes down. I think he's losing a bit of strength in his backs of his legs.
How old is he?
He's 8. They're 10 to 12, they live,
right,
the child.
Yeah.
So he's getting up there. But bless him, yeah, he'll get down. Nothing comes out. Then he scrapes his little feet behind him like he's putting his scent down. Then off he trots again. I'm like, there's nothing there. And then he tries again. He has like two or three goes at it. Poor little sod. Because he's had a booby bug before. Like, he gets doggy bugs. And I thought that he'd been poisoned. But he'd shat that hard that he'd lost the use of his legs.
I'm not laughing at fear. I'm just laughing at what our listeners will be thinking. Like, okay, so last week, periods, this week, diarrhea. Medical health and fitness,
this is my life. This is a constant. I have to watch how he poos. Oh, man.
Like that, what was that doctor who wasn't a doctor and she used to look at you? Yeah,
Gillian McKeith. What an idiot. Why were you looking at people's poo all the time? You could go, didn't she go on Deepole? Or wasn't it like an online certificate that she gave herself herself Dr. Gillian McKeith? What's she up to now? To be fair though, at the core of what she was trying to do.
Wasn't she like a nutritionist
She was trying to make people live a better life. And that's the most important thing is, you know, that's what she was trying to do. But when she absolutely shot herself in the foot when she went on like Celebrity Get Me Out of It.
I never saw it.
She played a bad... I mean, people tuned in because she was fainting all over the place. She refused to do any of the trials and everybody kept putting her up for the trials. So all the camp were like starving to death because she wasn't doing any of the trials. Oh, it was so funny. They were just the public kept voting her in to do it and she just refused.
Jillian McKeith is a Scottish television personality and writer. She is known for her promotion of various pseudo-scientific ideas about health and nutrition.
And looking at people's poos. She used to get people to poo in a little bucket. And then she, in the programme, would be examining it. Yeah, you know. I mean, you can look at... The thing is, you can have a... If... You should... not that you should be inspecting how you shit. But it is a clear indication if you've got blood and bits and pieces coming out your bumhole that there might be a bit of a fucking issue going on. Which is something that you... Like, on a serious note, right, whilst we're talking about poopy.
I've had my breakfast. Yeah. I'm good.
Oh, do you know what? I'm good with stuff like that. Yeah. It doesn't bother me. Like, people being sick and stuff like that. I'm not bothered.
Nah.
I'll get a little bit funny. Some of the kids that I swim with the snot coming out of their nose. It comes out and it wangs around a little bit and then it whips up back in their nose again. That starts to make me feel a bit queasy.
I'm just laughing because, yeah, I also like when kids cry and the snot comes out so much. And then it's like...
it's on their top lip. And then they're eating it. I've got these little, this teeny tiny, like, we've diverged off the poo talk to bogeys. I've got these little girls, right? And they're beautiful little girls, 4-5-year-olds in my martial arts class. And they'll come onto the mat, and as they're coming onto the mat, they've got their fingers trenched up their noses, picking them out and sticking it in their mouths. So I go, stop doing that. Don't do that.
Don't wipe it on the mat.
I had to tell Ariana, I got them all lined up last night. We're all practicing our jab and our cross and stuff like that. She's busy with her finger up her nose picking out a bogey, so I had to kind of say to her, take your finger out your nose. And just stand in your stance. That's all you need to do. It's a teeny weeny tiny little beautiful girl. Finger right up her nose.
Oh, that picture from Monday night. Oh, you look like you'd lost the will to live.
I didn't even you should
There was loads of them.
There was so many.
Oh, I can't stop yawning, but I'm not tired. I had a good sleep last night. My watch tells me.
Stop it.
Ooh.
Stop it. Right, what did we decide we were talking on today, Kelly?
Didn't you say we kind of wanted to go full circle? And right. And what do people ask you on a daily basis?
The time. What are you having for dinner tonight?
I ask my client, my 5:30 client tonight. Every time he comes in, I'm like, what are you having for tea? And so now he's started ringing up his girlfriend and going, what are we having for tea? Because Callie will ask.
That's terrible.
Well, Well, no, it's just because it's like...
No, but why isn't he making tea?
I don't know. I think just because it's easy for her to do it.
Okay, it's just the dynamic that they've got in their relationship. Yeah. She takes care of everything.
I don't think she's maybe a good cook.
Maybe she's a good cook.
Yeah.
And maybe, like most men, but I'm not saying all men.
But actually I am.
But most men need...
looking after.
Yeah.
Although saying that, I said to James last night, I went, is there anything special you want me to get from the shop? Because as we'll find out, I just buy the same stuff every week. Because one, I hate food shopping. It's the bane of my life. And two, I can't bother to think about what to have. So we just have the same thing.
Okay.
So then I'd gone and got the food shop. I'd gone to get my facial. 5 minutes into my facial, I get a text message. Oh, there's a big long list of stuff to buy. So I go back to the shop.
And
because he's gonna cook something. So, yeah.
Well,
so,
that's nice. I go through fits and starts. So I've got a main shop that I do. And I know that that's going to be fine
for
me.
Right? I'm like that.
And then every so often, what I do is I go, oh, I fancy something different. So then I figure out, I bought some recipe cards with me today. So Waitrose really good when you're walking out, right? They'll have free recipe cards.
Oh, yeah. Tesco started doing that for a while, didn't they?
So I'll go through the recipe cards and I go, oh, I fancy that, or I fancy that. So then I'll maybe figure out 4 main meals from my recipe cards and I'll do that. And they're really easy. I think the biggest thing with people cooking dinner is they kind of lose their creativity but they make it really difficult and it don't need to be difficult.
No.
It doesn't need to be difficult and it doesn't need to be expensive either.
Also, I quite like sometimes cooking in bulk.
Yeah.
And then you can just freeze a few.
Yeah.
Or if you make too much, so say for example you're living on your own, cook for two, have that in the evening and have that the next day for lunch or something.
I always cook for myself, even though I live on my own. Although I don't live on my own because I live with housemates, but we don't cook. Sometimes we cook for each other. I like Machida makes a very good curry. So she'll share that, which is awesome.
Oh, we've already established that me and James are coming round to try tea. So then she could just bung in a curry at the same time then if she wants.
Yeah.
No pressure, Rashida.
I know. Yeah.
I met her actually. I met her at your birthday.
Did?
She's really nice.
Yeah.
Well, I met her before, but only in passing.
Yeah.
And we did that podcast at your house, al fresco.
Oh, yes. Yeah, no, don't annoy it.
That accent is as good as my Dorset accent last week.
Go on.
My accent was horrendous.
If I think about doing a Dorset accent, it doesn't come out. But when I don't try, all of a sudden I hear it and I go, oh my God, I sound a bit slow. But anyway, so yeah.
Can I buy you a quilted jacket?
A what?
And buy you a quilted jacket and a flat cap.
Oh, shut your face. And a pipe. Get some wellies on. Get me wellies on. So, as far as dinner goes, I suppose it's about coming up with recipes, isn't it?
Yeah.
My favourite, and a few of my favourites, is we have talked about this before, I don't eat beef and I don't eat lamb. So when I make bolognese, I use turkey mince.
Yeah, I do as well anyway, just because...
I like turkey mince.
It absorbs the flavour quite a lot as well.
It does. So what you've got to do with the turkey is bump it up. So I'll chuck garlic in it and I'll chuck chilli in it.
Yeah. And otherwise it's really bland, isn't it?
And then I'll...
And dry.
And dry. But I'll use like a sun-dried tomato paste that you can get. It's got all kinds of spices
in
it.
Nice.
And I do cheat when it comes to bolognese and I'll buy a Lloyd Grossman jar.
Oh, no, he's nice.
Lloyd Grossman.
He's not nice, but the bolognese is nice.
I'm sure he's quite a nice guy, but you know.
I don't know, on MasterChef it comes across as a bit.
Okay, where's the evidence? Present evidence of what you're saying.
Yeah, is he not very good?
I don't know.
Was he conceited? I bet he's conceited.
Am I thinking about the right one? Yeah. No, I don't know.
He used to do through the keyhole.
Yeah. Who lives in a house? Stop living like that.
I can't do it again.
What is it?
Do it again.
Who lives in a house like this?
Yeah. But oh, that Keith,
that
Keith Lemon does it now, doesn't he?
Oh, no.
It's just, you know what, right? I used to watch... And we're going to digress for a moment. I used to watch Celebrity Juice all the time and I used to find it hilarious. I watch it now.
No, it's rubbish.
No, I don't find it so funny anymore.
Also, it's like, they should have... Right, when Holly Willoughby and What's-Her-Face left, and Keith Lemon should have gone, whoever Keith Lemon is, because it's not really Keith Lemon, is it? He should have gone, okay, I'll do something else. But he just started getting different...
Yeah.
star panelists. It's like, nah. I don't recognise half of them anyway now.
No. I do like the game show us your teeth.
Like, I've got to talk like that.
Oh, that's scary looking.
I haven't brushed them this morning. Maybe that's why. Only because I'm still in my house.
Okay. So yeah, you can show us your teeth. So yeah, you got to answer, like, show us your teeth. You don't need to look so scary.
I've got massive lips.
All you
got
to do is tuck them underneath like that.
Yeah, but I can't. I've got massive lips.
Like that. That's better. Anyway, so back to Lloyd Grossman, Back to Lloyd Grossman. I like his puttanesca sauce because it's got capers and stuff in it,
Which is quite nice. A bit peppery, a bit.
Yeah. And then, because if I make a lasagna, I like using the fresh pasta sheets, which is quite nice. And then I make my own bechamel sauce. So I'll use half fat mature cheddar cheese
in
that. And then the flavour from the mature cheddar, it just works really well with capers and stuff like that.
I might do that, actually, because what I do if I make a lasagna, I don't actually use pasta sheets. So probably it's probably not a lasagna. But
it's just your take on lasagna.
I cut aubergine, and I'm demonstrating that I'm cutting. Yeah. I'm cut aubergine lengthways,
that's nice.
And then I'll kind of like grill the aubergine a bit. Otherwise, it's a bit too sort of rubbery.
Yeah.
So it's got like then it gets like a little bit of a flavour to it.
Yeah.
And then I put that on. Then I make my own cheese sauce.
Yeah. Well, isn't that the bechamel sauce?
I don't know what is bechamel sauce.
Well, that's the bechamel sauce. It's the cheese sauce that you put in it. I can see your face glaze over when I said bechamel.
No, I know what bechamel sauce is. Is it bechamel? Bechamel.
Am I just talking up me off?
Bechamel. I am. What's it got in it? It's white sauce, isn't it?
Yeah, white
bechamel's
sauce.
White sauce, which doesn't have cheese in it.
Okay, well.
So you obviously make cheese sauce.
I make bechamel, but I add the cheese to it.
make cheese sauce. So white sauce, bechamel sauce, is whole milk. Onion, oh, that'd be nice. You put onion in it.
Oh, no.
Yeah, whole milk, onion, bay leaf, cloves, butter, plain flour.
Love that. Don't use plain flour when you make a white sauce. Use corn flour.
Plain flour, what? Why? What's the difference?
Plain flour's really thick.
Yeah, but you'd sieve it.
It's thick. Trust me. I've done enough cooking with the sauces. Use corn flour.
Do you know what I'm feeling? Do you know what I'm feeling?
What?
A Leave Nothing Out cooking episode.
Yeah. Do it
in my orange kitchen,
man.
Which was orange before we moved in, listeners, and I can't bother to paint it yet.
Anyway, so yeah, don't use plain flour. It's too heavy in sauces for my palate.
All right, I quite like a thick sauce.
It makes the corn flour makes a thick sauce. It's just you don't get that grainy,
the gloopiness,
glumpiness. Yeah, with the white plain flour.
Oh, I'll try it.
Cornflour is much better, but this is a Janine tip. This is a little tidbit. Now, when you're making white sauce, what they'll do, and what they suggest you do, butter in the bottom of the pan, flour in, you mix that with the butter, and then you slowly add the milk. Now, in my experience, you can end up spending your time trying to get the lumps out, right?
Oh, yeah, I do.
So what I do is milk in the pan, and if you want to make it low fat because you don't want butter in it, okay, and I don't put butter in it because I'm adding the cheese to it anyway, and if you've got onions and other bits and pieces in it, you don't necessarily need that butter, although, you know, I mean, I'm sure old Angry Chef Man will probably disagree with that, whatever his name is.
Gordon Ramsay.
Okay, because they all like a little bit of butter.
I was thinking of Naked Chef.
Because I suppose that the butter kind of gives it a little bit of depth of flavour, but, right, you want that
Why
out?
Do you usually use full fat milk?
Because I use semi-skimmed goat's milk.
Oh, right, yeah. But I'm just saying, like, if you wanted to take the butter out, would it just work with full-fat milk?
I'm sure it would, but, you know, I'm trying to make a lasagna that suits my dietary needs.
Yeah,
so I'm trying to, you know, half-fat cheese, turkey mince. It just makes it a little bit healthier.
Yeah.
So get your corn flour in a cup with a bit of milk, mix it up, and then slowly add it to the milk.
Do you know what my grandma taught me that?
Yeah, and then you will have no lumps. You've got to stay on top of stirring it. Don't have it on too high because it will burn the bottom and then it will burn your whole sauce.
Yeah.
That's my tip.
Yeah, I wouldn't put the butter in and then the flour in first. Mm-hmm. I'd always put the milk in, then a little bit of butter if I was putting butter in, and then I'd slowly add the flour.
If you watch any of the MasterChef programs, when they're making the sauce, they'll make it like butter, flour, and you mix that, and then you add slowly. But it's just a ball ache. So that's my take on lasagna. I love it. What did I do the other day? I tell you what I like to make as well. So if I'm not keen on lasagna, spicy meatballs. Cool. Love a spicy meatball. So turkey mince.
Yeah, I use turkey mince for like turkey burgers and stuff.
Tomato puree. So again, you can get the sun-dried tomato puree again, which is quite nice because it's just got a little bit of different flavours to it. And then I'll use like a spice mix. I add extra spicy Cajun mix, like the Schwartz mix. Chuck that into the meat, mix it, roll it, and then in a pan, coconut oil. The coconut oil's got to be hot. So when you put the balls in, it'll seal it. What? Go on.
When you put the balls in.
When you put the balls in, stop it.
I'm a bit funny, right? So I actually like chicken cooked in coconut oil, but for some reason I find coconut oil quite a powerful flavour.
I quite like it.
Yeah. I mean, I don't dislike it, but sometimes I'm like, maybe is it a bit too much? But it's each to their own.
Each to their own. But they, whoever they are, if you use olive oil doesn't
get hot enough.
No, it changes its structure, doesn't it? It doesn't burn at a high temperature because it gets carcinogenic. Whereas you need a hard fat that can reach up to a high temperature.
That is true.
So it's just better for your body. So that's why I use the coconut oil. But put your coconut oil in, and then I put in the balls in the hot oil.
Get
them right in there, seal them up, and then I chopped in peppers, aubergines, and fresh tomatoes.
I'm just thinking of someone teabagging in some hot...
Stop it. It's not going to be good. Style. You know there's some freaky deaky somewhere that's going to be doing that to themselves.
I was talking about that. I did say to that Dan that if he really wants someone to punch him, he could go somewhere and pay for that. I don't think he took that on board.
No, well, why does he need to do that when I can do that for free?
Charge him next time.
I know I will.
Did he get a bruise?
I don't know.
We need to ask. Dan, email in. Did you get a bruise from that? Send pictures so we can put it on our Instagram.
Yeah. And again, you know what? I literally can get in. I can get my meals done and my dinners done in half an hour flat. I choose meal recipes. I don't want to be there when I get in from work in the kitchen for an hour and a half cooking dinner. I need to be in that kitchen, food out, in the pan, boom, 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 done, sat down, eating, half an hour. Done.
Yeah, I think sometimes people who maybe aren't that confident will pick a recipe and it just a bit too convoluted.
Right, so look, I've got my recipe cards. So I picked up some new ones every day. I thought that was quite easy, toad in the hole. Ooh, that looks good, doesn't it? Easy toad in the hole. Do you not like a toad in the hole, Callie? That's like a weekend meal.
Do you know what? Yeah, I was going to say, looking at that, that looks absolutely delicious because the sausages are wrapped in bacon.
Yeah, and I won't have the bacon.
And there's some gorgeous, like massive, the northernness is coming out of me because there's massive peas and...
I think the Yorkshire pudding, the Yorkshire pudding.
Hang on, you need to put that down because it looks too nice.
I know, right?
Don't you dare buy the Yorkshire pudding. You make that Yorkshire pudding mix.
I'm proud that I was made in Yorkshire, and I'm proud of the things that we make in Yorkshire.
It's basically pancake mix and chuck it in the oven.
I'll do what I want. But anyway, right, so this looked quite nice as well. Cod with olives, spinach and lentils. The thing is, if you don't want to make the batter, that's what they're trying to do. They're trying to make it like you've bought the Yorkshire pudding, you've got the sausages. How long does it take to do the sausages? And it's just easy.
That is easy. It does say prepare for 5 minutes, cook for 30.
Done.
Yeah.
So this looks nice as well. Although cod doesn't always do it for me, but cod with olive, spinach and lentils. I thought that looked quite nice as well. Two of your five a day. So this is prepare 10 minutes, cook 15. Easy.
I like cod. I like cod, smoked cod.
Oh, and I don't like the smoke stuff. It makes me feel a bit queasy.
I'm taking pictures and I'm going to put them on our Instagram.
You might have to reference
Waitrose. Yeah, I'll reference Waitrose, yeah. Although there are other supermarkets available.
But I so this is another one. I like the gnocchi pesto and green beans.
They're quite high. Right, do you know what's happening to me at the minute? I'm looking at these and I'm thinking it's quite high in carbs.
I love my carbs.
Gnocchi. So this is one of my questions. How would you replenish yourself after exercise? Now, these are actually brilliant meals to have after training.
Definitely.
Because it's got high protein with the cod, which is low fat.
Yeah.
And then you've got high carbohydrates. I mean, you're getting fats from your olives, but they're good fats, aren't they?
Yeah.
Yeah, nice.
Don't get caught. Just, you know what, these are good, wholesome meals.
Yeah, no, I'm just trying to highlight
but
it
what
for
I'm
those
saying
that...
is that people like can get caught up in, oh, there's too many carbs and that. Carbs are not the enemy. We've spoken about this. Okay, they're not the enemy, but it's quantity of what you're eating is the enemy. Right, gnocchi with pesto and green beans. I thought that looked really good.
What is gnocchi?
It's a potato pasta thing, isn't it?
Is it? Let me
it's
take
Italian,
a picture.
Yeah, it's Italian thing. I thought this looked good as well. I like a little bit of halloumi.
Oh yeah, squeaky cheese.
Yeah, right, squash, it is squeaky cheese, but I like the flavour, I like the saltiness of it.
Yeah, I like
it. So squash and halloumi grain bowls.
Oh, I like things like that because you can chuck them in a bowl. And
take a picture.
How many are we doing?
Well, I picked up quite a few yesterday.
Yeah, just pick your faves.
All right, I'll do two more.
Oh, I've just seen ginger crunch creams.
Oh, I know, I was going to make those on the weekends. I picked up those. I thought they were quite nice.
I tell you what, I make a fantastic fat rascal. If anyone's been to Betty's Tea Rooms in...
Listen, you said you were going to make those and I was going to take one and I didn't take
them. They're in the freezer.
Oh, okay.
Well, I'll get you one out. Yeah. It'll be frozen, so you have to wait for it to defrost.
So I'll give you a couple more. Oh, actually, I'll give you three more. Because these are three that I do quite a bit. Okay, so cottage pie with sweet potato.
Oh yeah, sometimes I put, sometimes I do cottage pie with, obviously that is sliced a little bit like dauphinoise.
Yeah, it is. But you know what, sometimes you need to mash them.
Yeah, sometimes.
Because it doesn't bake very well.
Also, I live with a diabetic, so sometimes having too many carbohydrates in it is, he has to have lots of insulin. So I sometimes will mash up carrot and swede.
Yeah, nice. Yeah, lovely.
But so I like that. I like that.
Okay.
Made a mistake? Better rewind and repeat until you achieve mediocrity.
Are you on?
I'm in.
Today is another day.
Today is another day. Are you recording?
Yeah, it's all recording. Part two. So, you're getting two podcasts in one. Because I fucked up.
You did fuck up. That's all right. We're allowed to make mistakes.
Anyway.
So, how many boosters have you had now?
Four.
Oh, fuck that shit, Callie. Why are you doing that?
It's fucking ridiculous, isn't it?
Oh, do you know what? There's three things you don't talk about around dinner. Three things.
Politics, religion and COVID.
Yeah.
Anyway, it's done now. It was free. I think it's because I'm northern and anything free. I'm just like, I'll have it.
Fucking hell. I mean, at what point do you stop? At what point do you stop?
I think now they're going to do it yearly, though, aren't they? Like the flu jab.
Do you have the flu jab every year?
No. It's more like, also, as a health professional, the professional body want to know that. It's like I have to have my Hep B up to date for being a needler, dry needling practitioner.
Well, that's, I can understand that. So, yeah. When I was working on the door, I would have hepatitis.
Yeah.
Vaccination. Because people spit in my face, because people do that when you're working on the door, because they're horrific. All right? You're not going to be catching hepatitis. This is the thing about diseases, right?
We're way off course.
So, when I was dating a Hawaii boy, he lived with HIV. Now, I didn't tell many people about it because people are still very judgmental about it. And the myths that are surrounding that, you are more likely to catch hepatitis than you are to catch HIV.
Yeah. People can live with it now, anyway, can't they?
Yes, undetected.
Yeah. I think there was that Jonathan Vass off Queer Eye he's HIV positive and well, he lives with it.
The rugby dude, he's doing, the rugby dude was on the news the other morning and he is HIV and he basically, the medication that they have now for HIV means that you can live with the virus undetectable in your body.
And you can have offspring without passing it on.
I know. I did all my research. When I went out to live with him in Hawaii, I did all of my research. So no, people are dumb, unfortunately. And they go by the scaremongering as opposed to finding out what the research is. But anyway, we're digressing. Part two.
Yes, we finished off talking about your cottage pie.
Right.
And then we got on to sweet potato and creamy greens.
I'm going to make that today. I've got all my ingredients today. So I've got my cottage pie. Okay. Yeah, sweet potatoes and buttery greens.
That's it.
That's quite nice, isn't it? Add a bit of chicken to it. That's what we said, didn't we? Add a bit of chicken to it, a bit of protein. You could have white fish with that. That would be nice.
Yeah, that would be nice.
You know?
And the white fish would take on the taste of the, the butteriness.
Yeah. So I'm going to do that later.
But you've also, since the last podcast, you've actually made the salmon nicoise.
Did I talk about the salmon?
I think we did talk about it, but it didn't get the recording.
Okay. Right. So grilled salmon nicoise with pickled tomatoes. I don't do pickled tomatoes. I just put cherry tomatoes on. And then I tell you what I added to it the other night, and it was delicious. Garlic and herb dressing.
Hang on. 1 minute. What don't you put on?
Pickled tomatoes. I just add cherry tomatoes.
Oh, what's the difference?
Well, they're either pickled or not pickled.
Oh, yeah. Ooh.
Oh, poor Callie. You're not well today,
are
you?
No, no, no. I'm trying to think of... not the sunflower. Sun-dried tomatoes would be nice, wouldn't it? Oh, I like sun-dried tomatoes.
Do you know what? The sun-dried tomatoes would be too heavy with that dish.
I suppose.
Because you've got the fats with the salmon.
Yeah.
And then add the sun-dried tomato with that. It'll be too
greasy,
heavy. It'll be too heavy.
I like the eggs on that. It looks nice.
It's very nice. I sent you a little picture.
Yeah, I've got it. We'll put that up. I'm going to put a little reel of these on Instagram.
Man. Listen.
I was thinking about it this morning when you messaged me.
When you're in Waitrose... Okay, have a little look at the recipes because other supermarkets are available.
Ooh, you didn't show me that one last week.
Oh, yeah, that's
aubergine,
good.
Sweet potato and guacamole burgers.
Yeah, that's good.
I suppose that's for the vegans out there.
Yeah, but I tell you what I do, midweek, I do Waitrose. That's like my little treat shop. And then I do my main shopping at Asda.
Yeah, I do... I do that. I go to...
It's not expensive.
Yeah, I go to like a non-expensive one.
Yeah.
And then we'll go to like somewhere that has all the nice delicious things.
Oh, there's my other ones. Okay, so these are the ones that I'm going to make today. I've got squash and halloumi grain bowls.
Yeah, we spoke about that. Squeaky cheese.
Gnocchi.
Yeah, we spoke about that.
Good, with pesto and green beans. So I'm going to do that as well. Okay, so... We've got, if you want any ideas, just contact us. I'm always looking for recipe ideas and stuff that's really easy to make. Half an hour, sitting down, eat your food. So.
Yeah, we missed out all the sweet treats.
Okay, courgette loaf with lemon frosting. That looks good.
Yeah, it does look good. It's almost, for those of people who won't be seeing the Instagram just yet, it looks a little bit like a carrot cake, but I'm guessing they've just used courgette rather than carrot.
Toasted seed and nut tiffin.
Tiffin, very Yorkshire-based.
Okay, that looks quite nice. The chocolate salt caramel tray bake. Mmm, really good. That looks really good. And then the one you kind of lost your shit over.
Yeah, it was the ginger snap thing.
Hang on, let me get to them. I do have quite a collection here. That's quite nice. That tastes like carbonara.
Try and say that.
Kongligi.
I like how she just quickly sort of went over that. She's like, oh, that's nice. It's like, what did you say it was like?
It's pasta like carbonara. With mushrooms and spinach, but it's like carbonara.
It's basically the shell pasta.
It's a shell pasta, whatever you want to call it. But I tell you why it tastes so good. Because you use dried mushrooms in that. Can't use too many. They are really strong.
Oh, what are those dried mushrooms called? The thing with a P?
I will tell you. Puccini.
Yeah, puccini. Yeah, they're really strong tasting. Actually,
really strong. Because though it can be a bit sickly if you add too many. Oh, there they are. Ginger crunch creams. Let me tell you something.
I want to make them, you know.
25 minutes to prepare, 40 minutes to cook. That's nice.
How many? How many hours of exercise to burn them off?
It doesn't give any.
It doesn't give all that.
Do you know what? You don't need candles. No, I know. But if you're going to have a treat, innit?
Right. I'm going to say this now.
Stop it.
So, at the weekend, obviously we recorded this initially last Thursday. At the weekend, we go out for something to eat.
Yeah.
And I was sat with the person I was sat with eating for about 20 minutes while they figured out the calories that they could eat and what they could eat off the menu.
Why are you going to go out for something to eat if you're going to worry about that?
Right. All I was thinking about was the longer you take to order,
I know,
the longer it's going to take for me to get my food.
Yeah, antsy. Were you getting a bit antsy?
I kept looking to see if the waitress was going to come over and ask. And then...
Right, wait there, because I'm going to pause the washing machine, because that is going to start whirring in a minute, and all you're going to be able to hear is the washing machine.
I can already hear the washing machine.
Shall I turn it off?
Is it going to damage your washing cycle?
No, I just pause it.
Oh, pause it then.
Okay, all right, 2 seconds.
We're just keeping it real, Janine. This is our everyday life.
I know.
In between clients, doing our washing.
I know.
Fitting it in.
Trying to squeeze it in, my dog. Boo-boo. My dog's very poorly. He's very poorly. And he's lost a lot of weight. He's lost 3 kilos, which is a lot.
Yeah, he does look a little bit thin.
Yeah, but he's been poopy-doopying for over a week now, like 10 days. It's not great. And then he's been sick this morning.
You were talking about this last Thursday when I was saying how he was.
I know. He's not well, so.
Yeah. So we're just trying to fit this in between.
Yeah, we are.
Everything else.
That's right.
Yeah, so then.
Go on.
They have their meal, right. And I have my meal.
Right.
We're driving back. They stop off at a service station. They get back into the car. They have a Magnum. And they have a big bag of popcorn.
So what's that all about then?
Right. And then they ask me, do you want half of this? I'm like, no, I'm still full from the food I ate.
Yeah.
So that made me chuckle.
Yeah, I'm sure it did. The meal that you went out to enjoy.
Yeah.
Like, why are you going to go out for a meal if you're not going to just sit and just enjoy the luxury of being able to go out for a meal? If you want to count your calories, you do that at home, don't you?
Yeah. But anyway, so it just made me chuckle. Like, now they've got on menus... They've got the calories.
Yeah, we've talked about this before.
And also, what I have noticed is they've got the calories next to it, but I don't think they're right. There was one...
Oh, really?
So we went for a roast dinner on Sunday. Sounds like we go out all the time. We don't. It was just this weekend seemed to. So the roast dinner, if you had the beef, it was like 1,200 calories. If you had the pork, it was like 1,365 calories, something like that. If you had them both together, 1,025 calories. Something's telling me that's not right.
But they're accounting for, well, it was less calories.
Yeah.
Oh, that's not right.
Yeah. So it's not right, is it? No. So all I'm going to say is, if you're going to go out for something to eat, don't be worrying about your calories.
No,
just think about what's going to be on your plate. Have you got enough protein on there? Have you got, you know, good carbohydrates?
Just have a meal. Don't worry about it.
Yeah, no, but if you are going to be the type of person that worries about it, I literally just thought.
Don't go out.
I just thought, right. So roast dinner, I'm going to have meat, I'm going to have vegetables, I'm going to have some heavy carbs. Done.
When I go out for a meal, I look at the menu and I look at all the items on there that I think I don't eat at home. I don't want to eat something at dinner when I'm in a restaurant that I cook for myself every day.
Yeah.
Because that's just boring as shit.
Yeah, that is true. I don't seem to do that, yeah. Well, the thing is, as we said last time, I have the same... Like, these are really good ideas because I just basically cook the same thing.
Yeah, me too.
I have that like corn, like ratatouille kind of thing that you saw me cook that time.
It's easy.
I had a prawn biryani, which is basically vegetables and prawns and some spices.
Yeah.
Chicken and veg, salmon and veg.
Yeah, that's me.
What else? Or in the summer, chicken and salad, salmon and salad.
Yeah, exactly.
There you go.
I'll either have pasta. I do try to mix up the pasta, my rice, and the
sweet
potato.
I really like pasta, but it doesn't like me.
Oh, pasta's good for me, man. It makes me lift good shit. Can we have some period talk?
Yeah, I'm not on my period this week.
I'm fucking hanging. Mr. Boo's been up since 1 o'clock. I've been up and down all night because I've had bits of kidney falling out of me.
A chunk of ear.
It is.
All right, then.
I got through a whole bag of nighttime towels. That's how bad it's been last night.
Why don't we mix this what are you eating for dinner with, so what food do you eat when you're on your period? What do you try and nourish yourself with?
Oh, lots of energy. It's just whatever on my body. Do you know, I try not to think about it too much.
There you go, listeners. Go to Waitrose and buy a tin of energy.
Yeah, a tin of energy.
What does energy entail?
All right. Fucking hell. Right, so I'm not just going to eat protein, am I? I'm not just going to eat meat. So the most important thing is to keep your energy up. You've got to eat lots of carbs.
Yeah.
And eat carbs throughout the day.
Tell you what, do you know what I do like? Because it's a little bit of treat and it's carbs. Chocolate-covered rice cakes.
Oh, I love them.
Yeah.
I go with the yogurt at the moment.
See, the yogurt ones are a bit...
Well, if I have too much dark chocolate, that kicks up my shingles.
Oh, yeah.
So I have to be careful with that.
Do you want me to ask you the questions?
Yeah, go on, ask me the questions.
So we've kind of gone through what do you have to eat during a day. I think we did speak about that in the last recording.
But I don't think that was at the end of the recording when...
Oh, was it?
Yeah.
Well, so what do you eat during the day?
So an average day for me, I don't have my porridge in the morning anymore because of my insulin and the way that my body is responding to the lack of hormones that I have now. So I have eggs, avocado. I have that every morning without fail with my vitamins. And then I'll have a couple of, this is my routine. So if I'm going, usually I'll go for training after that. But on my way to training, I'll have a couple of malt loaf Lunchable bars. That'll give me enough carbohydrates to get me through the workout. Then after my workout, I've gotten into eating medjool dates because medjool dates are super fast carbs.
Yeah, you had a couple last week, didn't you?
Super fast carbs. And then I'll get in and I'll have a protein shake with my spirulina. So that's my recovery. And then I'll have a pasta dish with my tuna and salad. I try to eat salad every day. So I try to get in peppers, fresh peppers, radishes, greens, tomatoes. And then I'll have probably a couple more snacks. It might be natural yogurt, fat-free, cottage cheese with my beetroot rice cakes. I'll have that. And then I'll have my dinner at night. So that's just an average day for me.
So last time, I remember we had a conversation about what spirulina was and what was it good for. So literally quickly Googled it now.
Go on.
Rich in a range of vitamins and minerals, essential for maintaining a healthy immune system.
But it helps to alkaline your body.
Yeah, like vitamin E, C and B6.
I mean, if you're not sure about alkaline in your body, when you do exercise, it raises your cortisol levels. And stress raises your cortisol levels. And it can be very ravaging in your body.
Fancy.
The greens, spirulina, wheatgrass, barley grass, all that kind of stuff will alkaline your body. So it will neutralise any of those kind of, you know, ravaging hormones.
That's really important to chat about there as well, because stress is a natural thing.
Yeah.
So it's our fight or flight symptoms. But obviously if we go back to before we had all the minor little drip feeding of stress from everyday life, we'd only have like a big surge of stress, which would get us out of a situation or help us with a situation, and then it'd die down.
Fighting a tiger,
yeah,
a saber tooth,
yeah, or a T Rex,
because
as we all know, yeah, we were around at the same time.
That's so not true.
But nowadays, you just got that little drip feeding of stress. Like even this morning, someone just drove out in front of me. She didn't even look.
No.
That was one bit of stress.
Yeah.
Then I was driving down here, clicked my wing mirror, another bit of stress.
Yeah.
I have to be back at work for 12, another bit of stress.
It's just minor.
Yeah.
Minor stress. It's not like you don't get that sudden adrenaline release, but it's just minor stresses all day long.
But that minor stress all day long gradually causes
that
element of fatigue.
Yeah, that's right.
So having things in your diet like that would help.
We also talked about the fact that people with certain...
I was trying to find that.
Ultimately, if you're going to look into taking anything, make sure that you do your research on whether it's good for you or not.
It is, because it helps with the immune system.
It raises white blood.
Because it raises white blood cells,
it
may worsen autoimmune conditions.
That's it.
Such as lupus, multiple sclerosis and rheumatoid arthritis, in which your immune system attacks your body. So if you have any of those...
Don't take it.
Don't take it. Or consult your GP before you think about
exactly.
taking it.
Remember, we're not qualified to... All we're doing is giving you advice.
Yeah.
On what we do, on what I do. And then when people say to me, what do you do, Janine? It doesn't matter what I do. My body's different to everybody else's.
Yeah.
You know, but you've got to make sure that you do research on what's good for you.
So what do I eat during a day?
Go on, what do you eat, Callie?
I start my day with eggs. I have scrambled egg every morning.
Yeah, man.
And then I'll have like a couple of apples. Depends.
Do they not give you tummy ache? I can have one apple, not two. Give me tummy ache.
No, so it depends what I'm doing. So if I know that I'm going to be training later on in the day, yeah, I'll have like a bagel, yeah, with it. But if I know I'm not training until the end, like towards the end of the day, yeah, I'll just have like a couple of apples. Oh, we spoke about this before. So sometimes I'll have a banana, but I'll only have a small banana.
Mm.
But you said not to have that straight after training.
Not straight after because training. Depending on what your digestion is like, it can take up to 3 hours for the banana to actually leave your body. So they're not fast-acting carbs, bananas.
I'm just trying to sit back without making a noise to the mic.
Do you want some cushions?
No, I'm all right. I'm good.
Okay. Now, but a couple of bananas, depending on what your activity level is and what your body type is. You know, a 16-stone guy plus can probably get away with having, you know, 2-3 bananas, because they need, let's say, a highly trained rugby player who's training X amount of hours a day that cross trains across all kinds of energy sources will need that in order to replace what he's used. But for the average person, one banana a day is sufficient. Otherwise, it's going to bung you up and then you'll be shitting bricks.
Do you know what I was thinking about then? What? One banana, two banana, three banana, banana, four.
The Saturday morning. When I looked at that, actually, I looked it up. It's nothing like I remember it.
I was trying to think of what we were talking about the other week. Not me and you. I was talking about something in the gym, and it was about the 90s, and people were like, no, never heard of it.
What?
That's when you know that you're older, isn't it?
Yeah.
But it's all right.
Fuck them.
Yeah, the 90s were cool.
Super sexy cool.
Yeah, so anyway, so I have my eggs, and I have a banana. Yeah, so I have that. Then I have cottage cheese and pineapple.
Yeah, buddy.
Lunch, and a protein shake just to fill up the protein. Maybe another, it depends if I've trained, I might have some oatcakes with it as well. And then for dinner, it'll be like what I said, chicken, fish,
yeah,
prawns, veg, salad. And then I have my, before I go to bed, I have about 250 grams of Greek yogurt and a scoop of protein powder.
Love that. It's like having like
Angel Delight.
Yeah, it is, isn't it?
So at the minute, I've got a protein, I had chocolate and banana protein shake, which was really nice. And James ate the last of it. Ugh. But then he was like, but it's all right because I bought some more.
Right.
Then it was like, I think it's blueberry cheesecake flavour he got. I thought, oh, that's going to be disgusting.
Is it good?
Really, really good, yeah. Okay. Good, because he's got 5 kilos of it.
Oh, great. Right. Great.
Enough to last a lifetime, if necessary.
He's like, oh, I've stocked up. I was like, oh, yeah, no shit. But no, it is good. So anyway, so that's nice. Because then also, for me, if I was... So we were talking about this at the end of the podcast last time. What's all this you can't eat after 5 o'clock, 6 o'clock, 7 o'clock?
I don't know. That's to do with the fasting, isn't it?
Yeah, but if I had to think about not eating after a certain time, it stressed me out.
But the thing is, eat when you're hungry. I can't go to bed on an empty stomach. Keeps me awake. Yeah. It'll keep me awake.
That's what we said last time, wasn't it?
Yeah.
And you'll end up getting up and eating a bag of popcorn.
I'm a secret lemonade drinker.
I do sometimes have a banana at night when I take my vitamins, because I take vitamins in the morning and at night. So then I need something for the vitamins to bind to, so I'll have a banana. But is it tryptophan in bananas that helps you to sleep? There's something in bananas.
Oh, we did talk about that in a couple of episodes prior to this.
Like meal cares and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But that's like the Greek yogurt has that slow release protein,
that's right,
which helps kind of just steady you. And also, if you've eaten just before you go to bed, it kind of sits a little bit heavy in the stomach, which makes you feel a bit sleepy, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does. Well, yeah, because the body's working to break it down. Or the, you know what it's like when you've had a big meal and then you've got to go out and teach somebody. It's I just want to be at home laying down.
Yeah. So I always have that before I go to bed, which then makes me not worry about going to bed hungry. And I really look forward to it.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's almost like having a little dessert after your meal, yeah. But it's a couple of hours later.
Yeah. And it's good for you.
Yeah. So that's how I eat during the day. And then I've put, how do you replenish your energy post-training? Well, you have your module dates.
At the moment, or an apple.
And, yeah, and I was having, I'll always have my dinner after I've trained normally, so I've got my pineapple as my quick carbs, and then I'll have my oat cakes.
Yeah.
And my slow release.
Yeah. 20 minutes after training, eat proper meal within the hour.
Yeah.
Fast carbs. And then eat within the hour, proper meal.
Done and done.
Yeah, I've already asked you what's your thoughts on not eating after 8 p.m., the whole fasting thing. And if you listen to episode 10, we said that women shouldn't really be fasting.
No. No, and I think for most people that have a very sedentary life, and then they come home, and then they're just sat on the sofa with their slippers on watching soap operas for the rest of the evening. You probably need to stop eating at 6 o'clock. Because you've not done anything. You've not done anything. You've not exercised. You've just been sat on your ass. You don't need to be eating at 8, 9, 10 o'clock at night.
I'll tell you what we did during lockdown. We'd eat, and then to stop us from just snacking, we'd go for a walk, which helped.
Right.
So if some people, if they haven't done anything during the day because they've been sat at a desk, they come home, they have something to eat, and then they're just sat watching TV.
How many people do you think are going to do that?
Well, you never know.
You're so optimistic.
Maybe just go for
a walk. I like the fact that you like to sit on the fence with that. But realistically, how many people do you know?
Not many people.
That? Yeah, exactly.
Especially in winter. But you can't be bothered. The most difficult thing is getting out the door. Once you're out the door, you're like, oh, I'm out now. I might as well just go for a walk.
Yeah, but people are not like that.
Same with training, isn't it? That's the most difficult thing.
People are not like that. People are not consistent. They're not consistent. They don't eat properly. They think there's a magic wand. Oh, what are you having for dinner? What are you having for dinner? But it is quite good to come up with some ideas because you can get stuck eating the same shit all the time.
I've got something here which doesn't make any sense if you can remember what we were talking about. But listeners,
go on.
Favourite catchphrase for promo items?
What?
Is that
your notes?
It's written down, yeah. Listen.
Did you write that?
Yeah.
Why did you write that?
I have no idea.
You are an idiot.
No, I know what that is.
What?
Right. Say the sentence again.
Say it real slow.
Listeners.
Yeah.
Favourite catchphrase.
Yeah. Because we're going to put t-shirts together, right?
Oh,
and we want
the
listeners to come up with any of the catchphrases that we've said, so that we can put it on the t-shirts, you weirdo.
What the fuck have I written there? Yes. If anyone has any favourite catchphrases from our podcast.
There you go.
And then we can put it onto promotional items.
So try and get that done before Christmas. See if they can come up with something.
Well, so they can have stocking fillers.
Yeah, leave nothing out. Leave nothing out. Anyway.
Right. So what we're going to do, I'll put all those... recipe card. I took pictures last time and put the recipe card on Instagram. Obviously, I'll tag Waitrose in it.
No one's getting paid.
To say thank you for the recipe ideas.
They're good though, aren't they?
Yeah.
That burger looks really good, doesn't it?
It does look good. However, how much nicer would it look if it also had like a turkey burger with it?
I don't mind. I don't mind a vegan burger. I quite like it.
I don't mind a vegan burger, but sometimes...
A bit of mayo in it.
I like to have a bit of meat.
Yeah, me too, but it still looks good.
Yeah, it does look good.
But I will make a couple of the recipes, I'll send you pictures.
I think I might try and make some.
Okay. Come on then, let's sign off.
All right then.
You're tired today, I can tell.
No, I think it's in my head, I know what I've got to do for the rest of the day.
Okay.
So straight from here, I've got to go back into work.
You've got a lot of massaging to do.
Not so much massaging, I've got like a mix. Okay. Mix of PT and massage and rehab-y stuff.
Okay, I've cancelled everything today, apart from one.
I think sometimes you have to do that if you're not feeling well, though.
I don't feel unwell, but I've been up since 1 o'clock.
Yeah, so you just... I mean, there's times when I just think to myself, you'll be coming in and I won't be giving you the best.
No, I can't hold pads for a 110 kilo guy.
Yeah. I also feel like if I'm not in the best frame of mind, they're paying me for a subpar treatment.
When I could just rest today.
Yeah.
Yeah. But I say rest. I'm going to sweep the leaves.
Anyway, last time we forgot. Follow us on Instagram.
Oh, yeah.
Leave Nothin Out. Send us an email at leavenothinout@gmail.com if you've got any ideas that you want us to talk about, if you've got any questions. That's it, really.
Okay.
You're tired as well.
Oh, well, I've been awake since one.
Yeah.
And I've lost bits of my major organs.
On that note, we will speak to you next time.
Bye.
Bye.
Get ready. Wait. Leave Nothin Out.
Don't threaten me. You don't scare me.
Fun and excitement.
When your head is down,
leave Nothin Out.